Okay, I can do the Mangalacharan and then Bhakta Mugo, you can take over the class, yeah?
Okay.
I'll be there in the background, but you can take over. But I can, you can ask me to do the Mangalacharan. You can request me to do the Mangalacharan and I can do
Yes, please.
Thank you. Om Jnanatimirandasya Jnananjanashalakaya चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मायं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देहं श्रीगुरुं श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगना रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगना ललिता श्रीविशाखार्तंश्च हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी ऋषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय वांछकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभयेव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंदा हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण डिवोटीज थैंक यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग इन वी आर रीडिंग द श्रीमद् भागवतम वी आर ऑन चैप्टर टू Canto 2, Chapter 10, Verse 35. So, do we have any volunteers to read the Sanskrit? Maybe I can see how far Mataji is and somebody can take over.
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much, Bhakta Mogo.
And so we can do the Sanskrit study. We are doing Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 2, ch chapter 10, verse 35. As we wait for Mataji to join him in the Sanskrit. अमुनि भगवत रूपे मायाते ही अनुवरिमिते उमे अपि गुरुना नन्ति माया सृष्टे विपासिता. Somebody else can try. During Mataji, are you?
Hare Krishna.
Krishna.
Amuni Bhagavat Rupe Maya Tehai Anuvrite Upaya Binagri Nananti
I can try as well. Amuni Bhagavata Rupe Maya Tehi Anuvarnite Ube Api Na Ra Nanti माया सृष्टे विपाश्चिताः
Krishna, thank you. Pramila Mataji, are you able to try?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. I'm a little breathless today. So I wouldn't try. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Maybe we can go on to word to word.
I think we can go to the translation.
We can go word to word, Amuni, all these, Bhagavat, unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Rupe in the forms, Maya by me, Te unto you, He certainly, Anuvartnite described respectively, Ubhe both, Api also, Na never, Grananti accepts, Maya external, Srishte being so manifested, Vipachitaha, the learned one who knows. Hare Krishna, over to you, Bhakta Mova.
Yes, thank you. We can do the translation by His Divine Grace, Bhaktivedanta, Srila Prabhupada. Okay, Jai. I can read the translation and then maybe Doreen can do the purport. So neither of the above forms of the Lord, as just described unto you from the material angle of vision, is accepted by the pure devotees of the Lord who know Him well. Should I see our mentor today? Her Grace Radhika Kasturi Mataji has joined. Please accept our humble obeisances. And thank you so much for being here with us. Today we are doing Srimad Bhagavatam, continuing with Canto 2, Chapter 10, verse, we are at verse 35. Thank you very much. Over to you.
Yes, thank you, Hare Krishna. So we can get started, dear devotees. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuru Milita Mena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namavom Vishnupadaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swamin Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharini Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschaita Desha Tarini Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare. So dear devotees, we are going to get started. Before that, we'll just recite the Srimad Bhagavatam prayers. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Narayanam Namaskritiam Naram Cheva Narottamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayam Utire Shrinuvata Swagata Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana Hridayam Tastavya Bhadrani Vidunoti Sukrut Satam Ashtaprayeshu Bhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Guttam Asloke Bhakti Bhavati Nashtiki. Hare Krishna. So we are in the second canto, 10th chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam. And so today we will be seeing some of the verses from there. All right, dear devotees. So let's just quickly understand what we have seen, and then we will get into our verse for today. Not today, I'm not sure we will cover, but we'll try. So now, dear devotees, so we have seen how this process exactly works, right? What happens when the Lord glances, and what is created, and the three modes, how they are influenced by the time, all that we saw. So just to kind of give you a quick recap, we know that there is Karnodakshaya Vishnu, and Karnodakshaya Vishnu, in the Karnodakshaya Vishnu's body, Prakriti is there. Right, and we cannot question. And again, you know, in the Karanodakshanu, there are infinite jivas which are covered by their karma and avidya also. Okay, these are two things you need to understand. And first of all, the process how it happens is, I'll just do a recap. Okay, Krishna desires to create this loka, but this is not in the within the limits of time. We cannot find and we cannot question, okay, when this happened. Krishna, when he wanted to create this loka, he manifested Karnodaksha Vishnu. And in Karnodaksha Vishnu, infinite jivas are there, which are covered by karma and avidya. And in Karnodaksha Vishnu's body, Prakriti is also there. And if you were to ask this question, okay, since how long the jivas were there in Karnodaksha Vishnu's body, that is beginningless. And then we also have to understand this point. Karnodaksha Vishnu sleeps after annihilation and he then gets up from Yoga Nidra and he gets a desire to become many. When he sleeps and wakes up, there's no time there. It is Ananta. And then he takes out, he's in his body, Prakriti is there, right? And he glances on this Prakriti, and by that, the Jiva and the Kala Shakti is sent to the Prakriti. Then when this Kala Shakti is sent to the Prakriti, what happens? It becomes Pradhan. And finally, it leads to the production of what? The 24 elements. This is all happening in his body. And this 24 elements is responsible for the creation of innumerable brahmandas. And these brahmandas come out from the pores of Karnodaksha Vishnu. Again, dear devotees, why this again is not explicitly told by, I mean, it's kind of understood from the fact that we all know it is given in our purports that the brahmandas are coming from the pores of Karnodaksha Vishnu's body. Now, my question to you is, okay, I've mentioned this point, Prakriti is inside the body of Karnodaksha Vishnu. One may question, why Prakriti is inside the body, right? Are you all having this question or not? Why Prakriti is inside the body of Karnodaksha Vishnu? Now, it is an assumption because from the 24 elements, the innumerable brahmandas are coming out from the pores of Karnodaksha Vishnu. That means it's understood that Prakriti has to be inside. You're able to understand. This point is not clear in the purports. If you were going to understand and read it by yourself, it will not be clear. So I'm making it clear, dear devotees, please listen carefully to this point. Okay, why Prakriti is inside the body? Because we are telling, oh yeah, innumerable brahmandas are coming out from the pores of Karnodaksha Vishnu, Prakriti has to be inside. And from Prakriti comes Pradhan. Due to the influence of time, the 24 elements are produced. And from the 24 elements, we have, it is the cause for innumerable brahmandas. Hope you are able to get this point across. Yeah. So again, to become the brahmandas, that is to form these brahmandas by the 24 elements, he sends one more shakti called Bibhrit Shakti. And this Bibhrit Shakti is sent where? To the 24 elements to form the brahmandas. And this Bibhrit Shakti is composed of two shaktis. What are the two shaktis? It's Kriya Shakti and Jnana Shakti. And now, your question should be, why I am having this Kriya Shakti and Jnana Shakti? Right? Why is it there? That is there because the 24 elements don't know what to do. And that is why Jnana Shakti is given. And why is this Kriya Shakti there? The Kriya Shakti is there because these elements, they don't have the ability to do any action without Kriya Shakti. That is why Kriya Shakti is given. Hope you are able to understand these nuances. There are two elements that are sent to, again, to create the brahmandas from the 24 elements. He sends an energy called Bibhrit Shakti. And this Bibhrit Shakti has two shaktis, which is composed of two shaktis. That is nothing but Kriya Shakti and Jnana Shakti. Why Kriya Shakti is there? Why Jnana Shakti is there? These 24 elements, if you just leave it by themselves, they don't know what to do. And that is why Jnana Shakti, knowledge, is given. And then they don't have an ability to perform an action. They can be Jada. And that is why Kriya Shakti is given. Hope you are able to understand. And once again, so because of time, the 24, the from Prakriti, 24 elements came. And from 24 elements, what is coming? Brahmandas are formed because of what? Jnana Shakti and Kriya Shakti. And Prakriti is said to be within Karanodakshaya Vishnu, and he glances on her, and by that, the 24 elements are formed, and by Burbrit Shakti, the Brahmandas are formed on the pores. From the pores comes out the Brahmandas of Karanodakshaya Vishnu. And again, a very important point to note, Kriya Shakti and Jnana Shakti is given to these 24 elements and it's not given to the Jivas. The Jivas are still inactive. Okay? Who's this Kriya Shakti and Jnana Shakti given to? They are given to the 24 elements. They are not given to the Jivas. Note this point. And these Jivas, when they become active only when they receive body from Brahmaji. That is when the Jiva will connect to the external world. And now, if you look at it, Brahmaji is not even created yet. Right? Prakriti is sheltered in the Karnadakshaya Vishnu's body, but it's again not a part of his body. It is inside, but it's not inside. That is why it is called Achintya. It is inside the body of Karnadakshaya Vishnu, but it's also not inside the body. Hope you're able to understand this Achintya concept. And the pleasure of the soul is there until the soul gets its subtle and gross bodies. Once it gets its body, he claims the pleasure and pain of the body as his own. That's what happens. And again, there are so many Brahmandas that are getting produced and we are taking one Brahmanda. And now in that one Brahmanda, say for example, our Garbhodakshaya Vishnu enters into the Brahmanda, which is known as Mahasamasti Srishti. And inside the Samasti Srishti is made of these 24 elements. And then there are seven layers to this Brahmanda. If you were to consider one Brahmanda, then, you know, there are 24 elements inside. And then that's called the Mahasamasti Srishti. And then there are seven layers of Brahmanda. Like, what are these elements? Earth, water, fire, air, ether, ahankar, and mahat. And the portion of mahat that is given to the Jivatma is called Chitta. It is in the mode of goodness. And again, our individual body, if you look at it, that is also made of these 24 elements. Mind is made of tamasika, sattvaguna. Ahankara can be considered as consisting of mind and intelligence, right? In the seven layers, we sometimes say it is nine layers by separating the mind and intelligence. Okay? In Krama Mukti, the Jiva has to cross the seven layers. It will be explained in the third canto when we come. But again, we all understand this ego is out of ignorance. And ignorance is tamasika ahankara. Ignorance with more of rajaguna is rajasika ahankara. Ignorance with more of sattvaguna is sattvika ahankara. Again, the basic point that I want you to notice, ego is based out of mode of ignorance. Ego is basically out of mode of ignorance. And ignorance is tamasika ahankar. Ignorance with rajasika, ignorance is with more of rajasika is called rajasika ahankara. Ignorance again with the more of sattvaguna is called sattvika ahankara. It's not completely sattvic. That's the point. Okay. so now, this Garbhodakshaya Vishnu is kept in the Samasti Srishti, in his womb, he keeps the Samasti Srishti, that is the Brahman, I mean, he keeps the Samasti Srishti in his womb for how many years? 1,000 years. Then he divides the Samasti Srishti into three energies, that is Adibhutam, Adidaivam, and Adhyatma. And there is also space in the heart. There is a chunk in the space and it's called Hridayakash, which is the heart. And in the I mean, we'll be discussing about it more in the coming verses. As I said, three shaktis are produced in the heart, and adidaivam, which means the controlling deities, adhyatmam, which is the senses, and adibhutam, which is the sense objects. That's what we'll be seeing. Just like how the seed comes from, I mean, the seed from the seed comes the plant, and from the plant comes the fruit, and from the fruit and from fruit the seed comes. So the fruit is also there in the seed in the unmanifest form, isn't it? Similarly, this universe is made of adhyatmam, adibhutam, and adidevam. And the mula padartha or the seed form of those is created now. Okay. In the heart, there is a space, as I said, and the Kriya Shakti, which came from Karnodakshaya Vishnu, is now distributed to these 24 elements, which are present as Samashti Srishti in the stomach of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. And now that is making three energies, which is called Ojaha Indriya Shakti, Balaha, which is called Deha Shakti, and Sahaha is called Mano Shakti. And by the combination of these three Shakti, Prana Shakti is formed. Okay, once again, I repeat this point. See, in the heart, there is a space, and we all know, and there is Kriya Shakti, right? Kriya is because of which action takes place. And this came from Karnodakshaya Vishnu, and now this is distributed to these 24 elements. And this is now present as Samashti Srishti in the stomach of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, right? And that is making three energies again. What are the three energies? Ojaha, Balaha, and Sahaha. And by the combination of these three Shaktis, Prana Shakti is formed. So these Shaktis are subtle form, and from them, Prana is formed. Now the movement of Prana has begun. By the movement of Prana, what is going to happen? That is what will be seen in the following verses, dear devotees. Now there is a movement of Prana, the Prana Shakti is formed. And these three Shaktis are in subtle form, and as I said, the Ojaha, Balaha, and Sahaha are in subtle form, and from them, what is formed? Prana Shakti is formed. Now, there is a movement that's happening of the prana. And what is that movement of prana explaining to us? That will be seen in the following verses. Hope you are able to understand so far. Okay, so from here comes the 16th verse. Okay. So we'll be going over a few verses from here onwards, because I think now we've gotten the gist of creation. We'll be trying to understand, okay, what happens after this movement of prana. As the followers of the king follow the Lord, similarly, when the total energy is in motion, all other living entities move, and when the total energy stops endeavoring, all other living entities stop their sensual activities. That's 16. The living force, being agitated by the Virat Purusha, generated hunger and thirst, and when he desired to drink and eat, the mouth opened. I'll explain you what this means. So the Prana Shakti moves the chunk in the womb of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Okay? And when the Prana Shakti moves in the body moves. Right? Without Prana Shakti, the body is motionless. And due to this movement, what happens? Hunger and thirst are manifested. So in the chunk, the prana is moving, all the jivatmas are also there, and by the movement of the prana, the chunk now experiences hunger and thirst. And because of the hunger and thirst, mouth is formed. That's the sense organ. There is a reason why it's formed, right? So there is first prana shakti, and because of the movement of prana, the body is moving. And without the prana shakti, the body is going to be motionless. And by this, what is happening? Because there's movement, obviously hunger and thirst has to be manifested, isn't it? And now, because there is hunger and thirst that is manifested, mouth is formed. Okay? This is the first one. That's the 17th verse. Now, inside the mouth, tongue is formed. Say, for example, in our case, the baby's body parts are formed one after the other with the passage of time. We all know that. whatever we see is happening in the Brahmanda is the same procedure that happens in the individual bodies also. This is all we are talking about the Brahmanda, right? Brahmanda, and we are talking about how each thing is manifested in the Virat Roop, right? The same thing applies to the individual bodies also. The development of embryo in the womb. Now, the varieties of tastes are formed as the objects for the tongue within this chunk. Okay? Taste is formed. And now who decides how many varieties of taste are to be formed? Now, this chunk is in the womb of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. And as Garbhodakshaya Vishnu tastes in the spiritual world, the same spiritual taste, reflections are formed in this chunk also. The prototypes of what varieties of taste will be generated, it is all coming from the varieties of taste that is formed in the spiritual world, which is enjoyed by our Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. So the taste in the 24 elements is the Mula Padatha or the seed form. From that, now varieties of tastes are formed following the prototypes of what? The spiritual taste that is enjoyed by Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. The reflection of that is seen in the material world. Okay? Hope you are able to. I know it's hard to visualize it. But again, the point is everything is a reflection of what we see in the spiritual world. That's the point. If you can't understand it too much, don't worry. All we need to understand is whatever we see in this material world is the reflection of what we see in the spiritual world. The prototype, the chunk has, the chunk which is seen in the womb of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu is going to experience those varieties of taste that is coming from the spiritual taste that's enjoyed by Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Again, these are not transcendental, but these are reflections of what we have from the spiritual world. Now, Garbhodakshaya Vishnu has speech ability. Following the ability, speech organs are formed in the chunk in the womb. Okay? And the controlling deity of the speech, that is the fire god, that is also formed. And after the union of, say, the male and the female, the way the tongue of the baby is formed, following the mother's tongue, in the same way, this chunk, limbs are generated, following the limbs of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. So whatever Garbhodakshaya Vishnu has is what is the prototype for the chunk. The chunk is also going to have the same set of organs. It's going to have the controlling deity. It's going to have the sense organ, the sense object and everything. That's the point. And now, again, dear devotees, after this, Garbhodakshaya Vishnu has the desire to smell. And therefore, the Samashtri Srishti also wants to smell. And therefore, two holes are formed, that is the nostrils are formed. Okay? Then different types of smells, that is good smell and bad smell, using the 24 elements are formed, following the prototype of different smells that are smelled by Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. And the controlling deity of smell is Vayudev. He is also formed. Again, one question that may come to you is, okay, good smell and bad smell. We can understand what the good smell is all about. But what about the bad smell? In the spiritual world, do we have foul smell? Do we have that? Because we are talking this prototype or the Samashti Srishti is going to have different types of smells following the prototype of what is smelled by Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, isn't it? So now the question is, are foul smells there in the spiritual world? Again, if you ask that question, we know the answer. The bad smell is also transcendental in the spiritual world. And there is also ignorance and anger in the spiritual world, but everything is transcendental. That's the point. And here we are getting just the reflection of it. Okay. So now we saw nostrils are formed, the two holes are formed, and the Samashti Srishti using these 24 elements is able to have the formation of the nostrils. And now when Garbhodakshaya Vishnu desired to see, the chunk also has a desire to see. As the mother desires, the baby in the womb also desires the same thing, right? So two more holes, that is for the eyes, they are formed. You're able to understand the progression, dear devotees. Whatever we see in the Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, that is what is the, like how for a mother, for the baby, whatever the mother has, the baby will also have. isn't it? A nostril, eyes to look at, mouth to taste, everything. Whatever the mother has, the embryo also will develop those organs in a question of time. Same way, the Garbhodakshaya Vishnu here, he desired to see. Even the chunk or the Samashti Shrishti, it also desired to see. And then two more holes that are formed here, that is the eyes. And different objects of, for eyes like color, shapes, they are formed using 24 elements, following the prototype of what is seen in the spiritual world by Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Again, here in this material world, these reflections are formed by mixing of the modes. Different forms are made. And again, controlling deity, that is the controlling deity of the form, which is sun, is also manifested. And later, we will see that Brahmaji is giving these bodies to the controlling deities, which is the sun, Vayu, and everybody. Okay? So far, that body is not yet given, but yes, that will happen soon. And now, here we are seeing Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, he desired to hear, and the chunk also is desiring to hear. So ears are formed as the two holes. Right? Here we see two holes, that is the ears, and the object for ears, that is different types of sound and music are performed or formed using the prototypes of sound that are enjoyed by Garbhodakshaya Vishnu in the spiritual world. After that, what happens? Controlling deity of hearing is also manifested. So this is the point here, devotees. You're able to see the transition, right? How each one is formed and how they are nothing but the reflection of what is enjoyed by Garbhodakshaya Vishnu in the spiritual world. So far, we have seen up to 22nd verse, dear devotees. This is what is up to 22nd verse. And then, in a similar way, we will see there will be the Lord's desire is to experience the sensations, and based on that, a touch sensation gets formed. And then, Lord desires to perform activities. Based on that, we see the controlling deity Upendra is manifested, and then there is also an activity of move. That would the activities that would take place. And then 25th talks about the fact, okay, to move about, the Lord is moving here and there. That's due to his legs. And there is a formation of legs in the prototype too, which is on the Samashti Shrishti, and because of which the activity called moving takes place. And the Upendra is the sense devata for that. And then there is a desire to have sex and offspring. So for the activity is what? It's called procreation. And for that, what organs is, has to be generated? That is called the genitals. And then we have sense devata Prajapati. Okay? After that, there is a need. Okay, once you eat, you need to excrete. And for that, an organ has to be created, which is the anus. And the activity is evacuation. And the sense devata here is Mrityu, Yama, and Mitra. And then we see there is also, again, when it comes to consuming the food, it has to be digested and satisfied and filled in the stomach. And for that, abdomen is needed. So abdomen gets created, and then the controlling deity is Samudra. And then we also see, apart from consummation of food, there's also consummation of water, which is required. And for that, this activity that we would call for this is called nourishment from assimilation of rasa. And for this, we need an abdomen too. And again, the controlling deity for this one is Nadia. After that, the Lord's desire would be to contemplate this Maya and its created objects. And this is nothing but determination and desire. That is the activity. For that, heart is needed. And then the controlling deity is Chandra. So like this, dear devotees, we see there is a gross sense organ, there is a subtle sense organ, there is a sense devata that is formed due to the desire of the Lord. The same thing happens in the prototype as well. You are able to understand this is what is going on. In terms of what we see as far as the creation procedure goes. Virat Roop is also having the same desire as that of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, and it's due to that we are seeing that there is a subtle sense organ, cross sense organ, and then the sense devata that gets produced as a result of all this. Again, beyond the gross form is the subtle form. It is invisible without beginning and end, without expression, words and mental speculation. The wise do not accept both the forms of the Lord as they are composed of matter. Now, this is all creation, dear devotees. After this will come, after this comes what? Anybody? After this is going to be Visarga. Sarga is what we have seen till now. And Visarga is what is going to come after this. I know we spoke a lot. I mean, even though the time was very limited, I think we spoke a lot in terms of technicalities. Any questions here, dear devotees, before we move on? Because again, I just want you to appreciate what we have studied so far, because it's just not easy to get everything at the same time, even though we have an hour. I think I will probably wrap it up in the next 5 minutes, just to give you that time to recollect or review what we have learned today so far. Anyways, I think I will stop here, dear devotees, and then open it up for questions. Vancha kalpatarubhyasya kripa santu dhyaiva cha patita naam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namaha. Ananta koti vaishnav vrinda ki jai. Namacharya Srila Haridas Thakur ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Gaura Bhakta vrinda ki jai. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the devotees here in the forum. All glories to Srila Prabhupada and our spiritual masters. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Mataji, Dandavat Pranam. Thank you so much for this class. Mataji, two very basic questions. When you talk of Jivatma, the Jiva, it is the soul with mind, intelligence, and false ego. Is that correct? The Jiva
soul?
In the Virat or in the Chunk, you said all the Jivas are there. So are they what do you mean by Jivas?
Yes, the Jivas are there. What do you mean by that is, right now they are in the body of Karno Dakshaya Vishnu, and they are there for a long time now, and Brahmaji has to give them bodies. That is when they will identify themselves to the body. Till now, you know, there is no body with the Jivatma. They have their karma and avidya in them. The avidya and karma are there within the jiva, tied to each of them. But for them to be activated, they have to be given body. And that is when the question of mind, intelligence, and everything will come into play, because they are coming with a subtle body. The mind, intelligence, and everything is the subtle body. And the soul is different. The soul and mind, everything is different. The subtle body is something that comes when Brahmaji gives them the body. And that is when they would be activated. And that is when the Jivatma will identify and say, I am this body. They go with what the emotions of the mind are. I am this mind. I am fat. I am tall. I am CEO. I am this. I am that. All that comes because of the subtle body. And they identify themselves with the body. And the soul is Chit Padatha. It's Sachidananda. The soul, the purpose of this life is to help us understand, yes, you're not this body, you're the soul. You're the servant of Krishna. And because our body has this avidya in us, it's just not possible for us to identify ourselves as a soul. It's just impossible, because we have this component of avidya, which makes us feel we are not this body. We are not the soul, we are this body. There is avidya. And how would you get out of this? Okay, you're the soul, but you don't know you're the soul. How are you going to get out of it? That is sadhana bhakti. Sadhana bhakti, going on, reading our scriptures, helping us understand that Krishna's mercy has to come, spiritual master's mercy has to come to help us to get out of this avidya. We think, yes, the sole purpose of our life is to earn money, live a life, enjoy, and have a good time with family. That's the purpose of life. That's what we think. Yes, make more money, become a big shot, and be identified as a entrepreneur or good, I mean, whatever it is, good in whatever you do. That's what we think our goal of life is. But that's not the goal of life. The goal of our life is to understand we are not this body. We are servants of Krishna. We are not even saying, yes, we are soul. Of course, we are soul. Yes. One step above it is identifying ourselves as a servant of Krishna. That's the goal of life. And till we realize that, we will be born in the cycle of birth and death. Because we think we are this body, we are accumulating karma every time. I'm this body. Yes, I'm doing this. When you say, oh, the five elements, the prakriti is responsible for doing whatever, that's where the Kriya Shakti is and it's performing its action. When we understand we are not doing it, that is when we are out of our karma. And when we don't have our, okay, whatever happens, it's a will of Lord. When we are able to take that spirit, that time we disconnect ourselves from the body and we think outside the box and say, yes, we are servants of Krishna. And that's why we are able to think like that. Till we think, yeah, the pleasure is there, pain is there, you identify with the mind. I think everyday activities we identify with our mind almost constantly. So, but till we get out of that, Mataji, we are bound to the cycle of birth and death.
Okay, Matsi, thank you for that explanation. But coming back again to that question. So the subtle body is got the gross body, I know Brahmaji gives, but even the subtle body is got from Brahmaji. Before the Jivatma gets the subtle body, it is covered with ignorance, as you said, and karma. So this karma and avidya, I thought avidya means this ignorance that we are this body. But is
Correct.
that a different ignorance, or is this the same ignorance?
The same thing. Avidya means we are not, we are this body. That's what avidya is. We are not the soul. The soul forgets that it's not the soul and it thinks identifies itself as the body. That's the avidya component. And yes,
Okay.
karma, whatever you have accumulated over lifetime, over various lifetimes, that gets to you. And then Brahmaji gives the gross body and subtle body. Yes, you
And
will
the
be
subtle body is the avidya that you have got as a jiva,
mind.
and it continues in the subtle body.
Subtle body is the mind,
Mind,
intelligence,
intelligence, and ignorance.
and false ego, right? That's the subtle body goes with it.
Okay, so on top of that is the jiva. Jiva has the ignorance, avidya, and karma. So even if you burn out the subtle body, so the gross body gets burnt out. Due to your sadhana bhakti, you have burnt out, you have got rid of your anarthas, and you now don't have the false ego. Now you have understood that you are the servant of the Lord. It's still the karmas and ignorance will be there because you are a jiva. No, that will also get burnt out.
When you are become a pure devotee, everything will go away, Mataji. Everything will become transcendental, spiritualized. Your subtle body will also become spiritualized. If from how it is material, it will become spiritualized, and a component of avidya will not be there because you have identified yourself as a servant of Krishna.
And
So it's not
karma also.
also going to be burnt away. No more karma for a pure devotee. Once you have reached that stage.
Okay, Mataji, and another question. So in Garbhadaksha, Vishnu felt like the taste, and therefore we got the taste, and then the presiding deity of taste is so and so. So even the presiding deity, will Garbhadaksha, Vishnu also have the presiding deity, or it is just for us?
Just the Virat Roop, we are talking about the chunk or the Samashti Srishti, which is the Virat Roop, which is desiring all that. It's not the individual body that we are talking about. We are talking about creation here, which is the Virat Roop. The chunk is the Samashti Srishti, and with the Virat Roop, each and every organ is formed. That's what we are seeing. And just correlating that to what happens with us too. It's the same thing, like how a mother gets these organs, like that the child also gets. That's what I said. It's not like we are talking about the individual form of the body as yet. You're not talking about the jivatmas. So we need Brahmaji for that. It's now Virat Roop that we are talking about. After Virat Roop, we are going to talk about Visarga. Visarga is when Brahmaji's creation and how Brahmaji gives body to living entities, that will be discussed. So it's just what we are talking about here is Garbhodakshaya Vishnu's desire, and because of it, the Samashtu Shruti, which is in the womb of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, is also having the desire, just like how a mother, when she desires, the baby also has all these desires, and because of which the various organs are formed. Like that, each organ is formed in the Samashtu Shruti, which is the Virat Roop.
And the Virat Rupa will have the presiding deities as well, or that comes in Visarga.
Each sense organ is associated with the sense devata. Because of the sense devata only, we are able to do a particular action. If, say, for example, the subtle organ is able to move, if we are able to see, that's due to the will of the sense devata that it's happened. When the sense devata says, "Oh, Radhika can't see, then I can see." That's the point. We are all operating under control of a all sense. All the senses are working in the direction of the sense devatas.
Similarly for Virat Rupa as well. They
Correct.
also are governed by the sense devatas.
Yeah. So with the prototype of Virat Roop, we are having all the same things.
Okay.
We are a replica of what the Virat Roop has.
Got it. Thank you so much for that clarification.
Yeah, sure. Very good points, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. We open it up to other devotees. Bhakta Mugo, kindly take over. Sorry. I interrupted.
Hare Krishna, thank you so much, Mataji. That was
Yes.
wow, such a deep class. Yeah. And making
Yeah.
things clarity. I don't know whether there's anyone else with a query. I thank you also, Professor Kritika Mataji, for those great questions. We are learning in them. Really good. I think we can end there for now. We can go and yeah. So we can do one Mahamantra in glorification of today's class and Her Grace Radhika Kasturi Mataji for that great class. I kindly unmute
Thank you.
we Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare
Okay.
Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Okay.
Vajja
Okay.
Garbhodak Yascha Vajja Patitanam
Namo Hare Krishna, dear devotees. Thank you and see you all next. Hare Krishna.
माता जी, हरे कृष्ण माता जी। Hare Krishna Mataji, the class is finished or is going to start? Hare Bol. Nanan? No. Okay, so Prabhu, what can you know that do? Maybe we need to unajua just using the shocks and you say una war na like kuna hizo shock na scared au sana la migani unajua hizo ndio sijajua.